Hi guys, welcome back. My name is Gerard and today I want to do a quick unboxing video on the new Element Helix. So stay tuned. So first of all, let's speak about the packaging and how you will receive your scope. You will receive your scope in a nice looking box like this, very strong and sturdy. On the top it says Element, and the side it says 6 to 24 by 50 Helix. And if you swing it on the side on that side, you will see it indicates the reticle of your choice. By the looks and the feel of this box, it is very strong and very sturdy. So the chances of your scope being damaged and arriving at your house will be very, very little. So let's open up the box and have a look inside what you're gonna get. Take the cover off. All right. On the top, there's a small piece of foam that they've put here to protect all the interior parts and the scope itself. By taking that off, I can see there's a small little plastic packet. And inside the plastic packet, it looks like there's an owner's manual. I can see there's a spec sheet also that they included to tell you all the specs about the scope and what it's about. On the other side, if I have a look at it, I can see there's a reticle guide. On the reticle that you've selected with your scope, it tells you exactly what every little thing means on the reticle. That looks very nice. I'm pretty sure if you go through the manual, there will be much more data inside that you can have a read through. Then, if I have a look on the top here, there's a small little tool kit. And by the looks of it, there's small Allen keys as well here. These Allen keys, I guess you will use to adjust your scope and to, I think, to tighten down your zero stop. Very awesome. Then there's a small little packet. If I have a look at this, it's a throw lever that you get with your scope that you can put on there. There's also a small little grub screw. If you don't want to use your throw lever, you can put the grub screw in the little hole to protect it. Nice little Element Optics sticker that you can put on your gun box, which is cool. Then if you have a look at this, you can see this is the most important part for me, is how the scope is basically packed. And if I have a look at this, there's a nice thick foam layer to protect the content inside this box. It's nice and sturdy. You can see there's no way the scope is going to get damaged once it's reached you. So let's have a look what's in here as well further on. This is a cleaning cloth, which is awesome for all the guys that's outdoors for dusty areas, to take this cloth and just clean off your scope. Then there is a sunshade, which is awesome for this kind of level of scope, and to get a sunshade with it is a huge, huge plus. So that is very, very cool. Then there's flip caps. I can see nice little flip caps that you can go onto your scope. You get obviously the set with it, which is also very, very awesome. You don't usually get flip caps with your scope when you usually buy it. And then you get to the important part, which is the scope. Now the scope itself sits in a little plastic packet like this. I'm just going to take this little rubber band off and take it out of the packet. There we go. Super, super awesome. Very nice looking scope. I can see even the flip caps that you've received with your scope, there's an extra, looks like rubber caps that sits in the front and the back. It's like lens protectors, which protects your scope as well when you don't want to put the flip caps on there, which is awesome. That's a very good thought of Element to include both of them in there, because usually you only get one of them. You usually get the caps or you get this rubber caps to protect the lens. Then its scope itself, there's a small little tag on here. I'm just going to read the tag quickly here. It says quality guarantee, technical inspection, and with a little stamp on it. So there's a quality check that's been checked on the scope by an individual in the factory, obviously to make sure that there is quality control on these scopes, which is awesome. It tells you that they've really, really went a step ahead to make sure that they get the best quality out of this whole setup for you. And by the looks of the scope, on the fly, if I look at it like this, is very clean, awesome. The turret looks nice and crisp, it's nice and big. If you can hear the audio, I'm just gonna turn it for you like that. That's just music to my ears. So that's what you will receive in the box. Let's just have a quick talk about the rest and what I think about the scope if I have it in my hands. So the first thoughts when I have the scope for the first time in my hands, the first thing that my eye see is this awesome turret systems from Element that they've designed. It's nice and large, especially for guys like me with big hands. Small turrets is very, very difficult to grab onto, but this large turret is easy for you guys just to quickly grab onto it and quickly do adjustments. And again, if you listen to that elevation, that feedback that you get from the clicks, it is solid. You can really, really feel that the scope is really built well, especially for a scope in this price range. The next thing that I see is the magnification ring. Also a very nice sleek design for having a nice grip on the magnification ring. There's a small little grub screw that I can see that's been inserted into the hole where the quick throw lever screws into, which is awesome. It protects the little hole from dust getting in there. The next thing that I do see as well is on the magnification indication side, there's a red 6, there is a red 12, and there is a red 24. Now I know exactly what this means, and for, like I said, for a scope in this price range, it's very, very odd to see this little indications on it. For you guys out there that do know what these indications mean, do leave me a comment down below and tell me. But I just want to see if you really, really know what that 6 and 12 and 24 is for and what it really means. The next thing that I do see is the color of the scope. It's a nice flat black. I don't like a shiny scope, that's just my personal choice, but I really think that Element, the finishing off of the scope looks very, very nice. If you go to the back side here, obviously there is a eye relief section here that easily adjusts as well. And then the overall scope itself, if I have it in my hands, it's not heavy, it's a nice light scope which you can put on any rifle. This gun I'm gonna mount on a 22 250 and I'm gonna put it on a firearm, but for all the air gunners out there, this scope is an awesome, awesome scope to put on an air gun as well. If you look at the parallax side, I can see for the air gunners, it comes down all the way to 10 meters or run about 15 yards, which is awesome for the air gunners out there. And then it goes all the way up to 300 and then obviously infinity, which is real, real cool. Then it's an MRAD version, obviously, and it's one click settings on the top. For one click is 1/10 of an MRAD. So that's just awesome. For me, I like to shoot MRAD, but I do shoot MOA as well. So I'm not really full of nonsense when it comes down to that. So I don't really care as long as it dials and it keeps its accuracy when turning this knob. So it's time to put this little baby quickly on a 22-250, which I'm going to be using for tomorrow's hunt. And what I've done now off camera, I'm not going to go through that whole video with you guys, but what I've done already is I've leveled out the gun. There's a lot of videos out there how to put a scope on proper onto your rifle. So if you guys want to have a look at that, just go into YouTube. A lot of videos on that, you can check it out. So obviously what I've done is just put a little drop of oil inside the rings. I'm gonna put that baby on top there. Just make sure it's pretty much in the center. Now the biggest thing for me is obviously to get your eye relief fixed up and make sure that the eye relief is correct. That's the way you're gonna adjust it. See how far forward or how far back you need to set your scope. It looks pretty awesome on that distance. The next thing that I'm gonna do is obviously just put the little top side of the rings on there, and I'm gonna torque it down with my little torque spanner on the right settings. There we go, scope is mounted on top, and may I say it looks beautiful. I'm super excited to get the scope going tomorrow on the hunt, and I will be definitely taking some videos for you guys to check out. Thanks for joining me, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Cheers.